Greetings. As if this topic is not hard enough to address in an organized way, the torrent, the flood, the tsunami of evidence and events is overwhelming. But it is important to first complete a discussion of true and false information. Remember, the safe place we are told protects us from the strong delusion, and the lies the strong delusion will condemn you to believe, the safe space is to love the truth, and, by extension, pursue the truth, because you love the truth. Well, that sounds nice, but how can you benefit from the desire to pursue if you do not know how to pursue? One lesson Christians should learn from science and engineering is calibration. Calibration, to compare and correlate the readings of an instrument against those of a standard. For example, you can calibrate your car's speedometer on a known measured distance of road. Radars used by police must be calibrated to know they give an accurate measurement. When you are able to sample the sensor or instrument, you then compare it to a known standard. If it does not match the expected standard, you recalibrate the instrument if possible. You must do the same with each information source you listen to. You must calibrate the information source to measure it when you have a known source. There will be many stories you have no way to verify or corroborate. You calibrate your information sources on those you can confirm, on a standard when you know the truth. We have had two events in less than a month that prove American mainstream news is garbage. The story against the Covington Catholic boys was a fraud, a lie. I won't relive all the details, but I can think of very few details the news and leftist media reported correctly. There were boys, as defined by normal human anatomy. Many were wearing hats with Make America Great Again. Virtually every other detail of significance reported by the leftist liar fake news was false. The boys approached the peaceful drum-beating Indian. False! The longer video footage shows the Indian approached the boys. The Indian was a Vietnam War veteran. False! Fox News interviewed the man, and he stated he was not a Vietnam War veteran. The media created that lie to garner sympathy for the drum beater. The media knows that conservatives and Christians have an honest respect for military service. Remember this ploy of Satan, because it often arises to use your morality against you. The stories claim the boys chanted, "Build the wall!" False. Not one single video has been produced capturing such a chant. And there is a video longer than an hour of the event. I won't belabor that story. Stefan Molyneux has an excellent review of the facts. His video title is "The Truth About the Covington Confrontation." The second story is the deceit by Jesse Smollett claiming an assault and near lynching by Trump supporters. ABC had a 16-minute one-on-one interview, more a sympathetic platform to demonize Trump supporters. The whole claim of assault is now proven false. His entire story is fake, a fraud, a lie. I have yet to see an ABC News correction or withdrawal. They are holding the line for the lie. And this is where you must calibrate. The news that got these stories wrong will get most other stories wrong. Getting it right or getting it wrong are not accidental chance, but bias-driven awareness, or more properly, lack thereof. Every news source that rushed to repeat the false information has a bias and cannot be trusted. Like it or not, every story those sources produce is at best filled with biased spin and half-lies. You open yourself to deception if you take any information from those sources. Even the weather. Not even the weather, Tex? No. Weather worst of all, because their agenda is fear and manipulation. Look at Communist AOC's green scheme and the fear she screams.
The world will be destroyed in 12 years if we don't do something.
Destroy freedom, liberty, and civilization.
Right now!
If you do not sell your car and buy a golf cart, you want to destroy the planet.
Well, nobody wants to destroy the planet, so we gots to support Ms. AOC. Several years ago, my wife and I went on a vacation and, while gone, had our TiVo record nightly news on two channels. Once we returned, we binged on the news, 6 episodes in a row. Doing that gave us an interesting insight into the news pablum, especially the weather. Each night came with dire reporting of 35 million in the path of the storm. Oh, what storm? Oh, it does not matter. We've done this several times since. ABC was the worst. The others were not much better. Every storm is the result of global warming. 58 million in the path of the storm. 35 million threatened by the storm. The verbiage is extremist and dire. The numbers are exaggerated for effect. The agenda of the leftists controlling the media and news outlets is to make you cower in fear and submission. Until you accept the lie and will not even doubt it, let alone fight it, deniers will be shamed as idiots and morons, like birthers who would not accept Barack Hussein Obama's fake Photoshop birth certificate as real. That is another calibration point you must bear in mind. When they need to create a new name-calling word to attack you and defend their lie, you can know their information is false and not something you want to turn your brain off to believe. The lies and fake news are all about manipulation. Consider the leftist response to the Jussie Smollett fraud. Some have said, tweeted, they need this story to be true. Need the lie to be true. That leaves me slack-jawed. Remember that leftists murdered up to 200 million people last century. Maxine Waters is already calling for violence against Trump supporters. The Jussie Smollett fraud is needed to justify attacking and eventually even killing Trump supporters. Oh sure, the left will claim you cannot blame murderist socialism on the acts of a passionate few. Socialism is a worldview of peace for the people. And Trump is a racist, so are those who support him. They are racists. And racist words are violence, so leftists can use physical violence in response. That is being taught on college campuses right now. Kids programmed as weapons by leftists. This is part of the insanity those under strong delusion will participate in. They will be manipulated as part of the social media mob. Just like they have to vote for the first unqualified black man running for president,
or you're a racist.
Just like they have to vote for the first female who ever runs,
or they're a sexist.
Just like they have to vote for the first sodomite who ever runs,
Or they're a homophobe.
Just like they have to vote for the first trans thingy whoever runs.
Or they're transphobic.
Vote against bad ideas. And socialism is a fatally flawed idea. Google Venezuela. That's obvious. It's a little harder for the globalist socialists in Europe to grasp their fatal error. But death is coming to European Western civilization. It is past the tipping point. So, calibration. Learn that most news sources are presenting an anti-Christian spin. They already glorify Islam and demonize Christians. They will fit hand in glove with the Antichrist. When you search with Google, realize their algorithms hide the information you may be looking for. And for a good laugh, I noticed that CBS News now tries to introduce itself as real news. If they have to call themselves that, they're admitting they are not real news. Prepare your hearts and your minds for persecution, getting shamed, maybe getting fired. There may be times of hunger. Consider them a holy fast and subdue your flesh. Proverbs 29:27. An unjust man is detestable to the righteous, and one whose way is upright is detestable to the wicked. Recall anyone calling you detestable lately? Deplorable? Notice, we each consider the other's behavior detestable. An unjust man is detestable to the righteous, and one whose way is upright is detestable to the wicked. That is representative of the eternal conflict, Christ versus Antichrist. 2 Corinthians 6:14, Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship has righteousness with unrighteousness? And what communion has light with darkness? John 16:33, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take courage. I have overcome the world. I tried to be fair and balanced and looked for some scripture that said the world would love Christians. But the only love in this interaction is God's love that we can muster to show. The best encouragement I can offer is that the world does not hate us as much as it hates Jesus in us. John 7:7. The world cannot hate you, but it hates me, because I testify that its works are evil. John 15:18. If the world hates you, understand that it hated me first. Matthew 10:22. You will be hated by everyone on account of my name, but the one who perseveres to the end will be saved. Matthew 24:9. Then they will deliver you over to be persecuted and killed, and you will be hated by all nations on account of my name. To be fair, some of these scriptures only apply to the last days. Oh, wait. We're in the last days. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Revelation 22:20. He who testifies to these things says, Yes, I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.